Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. Today we'll be building a project in Python using Flask and we'll be working with some stocks data. I've partnered with Microsoft Canada to show you how you can utilize GitHub Actions to test or deploy your web apps. In today's video, we'll be taking a Python Flask app and we'll be using GitHub Actions to deploy it to Azure App Service. Let's dive right into the code. So here I've got some Python code and you'll see how it uses Flask, and we'll go over the entire code file here. So I'm using a bunch of libraries and packages. If you're not familiar with how libraries or packages work, it's really similar to if you have worked with React or Vue or any of the other famous JavaScript frameworks. You do an import and you also use a pip, which is a Python package manager, to install those locally. Here you can see we do a bunch of imports on the top. First one being Flask, since we are using it as our web application framework. And then I have pandas, JSON, and then here's an interesting one, which is called Plotly, and you'll see where it is being used. So Plotly lets us build graphs easily. It's a library which you just feed data into it and it gives you cool graphs. And since today we'll be working with stocks, that's where Plotly will come in handy. I've also imported YFinance, which stands for Yahoo Finance. So Yahoo Finance is available as a package or a library which we can interact with to get our stocks data. If we scroll down, I have app.route. At the default route, which is the slash, we have the index.html which is being served, and you'll see what that index.html does. But then we go over the other endpoints. So we have one called slash callback slash endpoint. Right here I do have a function which gets me the stock price based on what the arguments are. So we'll collect some data through our website. So I'll have a drop down which you can select based on which stock you want, and then another drop down which will let you pick the period, and then we have another argument that you can select, which is the interval. So all of those go in here, and then we get JSON dump using, we get the JSON data back from our Yahoo Finance library. So that's our first function. We have another one which helps us build the Plotly graph. So it returns the JSON data for the Plotly graph itself. So when the stock market opens, there is a maximum, right, and the minimum given stock, how it performed for a given period, and that's what's being done here. So, you know, we do some margin calculations and also make sure it is being visually, you know, displayed properly in our Plotly graphs. So this is what that function does right here. And then all of this code will be available on my GitHub. So if you want to reference it, you can find it on GitHub. So after we have got our JSON data, build the graph, and then it returns it as graph JSON. So this is the two functions that we are using. And then we also have a default. We also have the index.html that is being rendered at root URL. Going over the index.html, this is where we have built our UI. Users can pick the period, the interval, the stock that they want to see. This is also where our graph will be displayed that is built using Plotly. So nothing complicated is going on here. And you can see I have kind of listed a few options. I have only picked a few of the trending tech stocks, and you can see here's a drop down that you can select from. So Microsoft, Facebook, Apple, Google, Tesla, Amazon, and Nvidia. I can add more, but these are, I think, the most interesting tech stocks right now. And then you also have a column for a period, and then you can select the period itself. I have chosen the options of from 1 day to 5 years, and then, you know, 5 days, 1 month, 3, 6, and then a year, 2 years, or 5 years. And then I've also picked interval. When we pick the graph, how huge the interval needs to be between two data points. So 15, 30, 60, 90 minutes, and then we go into days, especially when you're picking, you know, the years or the months. I think days go well that, otherwise you're just looking at too many data points. And also we might hit a rate limiting for the YFinance API. This is all being displayed on index.html. I'll show you. So if we run our Flask app, right, so Flask run, and keep in mind I've already done pip install all of the packages that we talked about on the top here into my virtual environment, right, and now I'm good to just run Flask. And this would give us server that's running on port 5000. So if I copy this and then go into my browser window here, hit paste, you'll see the index.html loading. So this is what our index.html is serving. We have a few functions working in the background that gets us the stock data, and it is being displayed on this graph. You can pick another stock here. Let's go with Apple. And if I click on fetch stock, you'll see we are fetching Apple stock for the last day, and the interval is 15 minutes. If I go back to Facebook and change this to, you know, 1 month, let's go with 1 day and hit fetch stock, and you can see it is fetching the stock price for the last 30 days, right? And the interval is set to 1 day. This is how the app works. And then you can also see the day high and day low on the left hand side. And shout out to Coding Room, because that is where this is inspired from. But yeah, this is our stocks app. And now we'll get into the interesting part where we deploy this to Azure using GitHub Actions. And anytime I make any updates to the GitHub code itself, so let's say I commit new changes to my GitHub repo, all of it will be deployed automatically to our Azure app service. So it utilizes GitHub Actions for continuous integration and deployment. And here is some documentation that is available from GitHub. As you can see, it says deploying Python to Azure app service. But first, we need a few things in Azure, and that is our resources. So if I go into my Azure portal here, I have already created a resource group called Python Stocks. I'll be utilizing that today, and let's go ahead and create an app service as it's needed before we configure our GitHub action. So what I'll do is I'll go back to my terminal here, and I have installed Azure CLI so that I can interact with my Azure account or Azure portal through CLI. And I'll be using the command line today to create my Azure app service. And you can see I'll name this, you know, Python-stock and maybe some random numbers behind. So let's go with 07. And then for the resource group, we already know it's called Python Stocks. So I have az app service plan create, and then that command helps me create the app service plan that's needed. And we list a few arguments such like resource group name and also the platform I'll use, and which is Linux. So as soon as I hit enter, you can see it did create a Azure app service plan for me. Now we have to create a web app, since you know we are using Flask to create our web application. We need a web app in our Azure app service plan. Now if I go to my resource group, which is Python Stocks, we should see an app service plan, right? And if I click on that, you can see it did create us an app service plan. And now if I go to home and let's create a web app, let's click on create, it'll ask us to either create a new resource group, which we are not gonna do that because we already have one. For the instance details, let's go with Python Stocks. So Python Stocks is available, that's awesome. We'll use the code as the runtime, and the runtime stack is gonna be Python, and we'll go with Python 3.8, right? And for the location itself, we'll go with East US, and then it'll automatically select the Linux plan that's available for us. It was the Python Stocks 07 that we just created, right? So this is the app service plan, and you can look into more documentation on how the pricing works, right? Because it'll need to be different than the basic plan if it's a production app. For me, it's, you know, I'm just doing this for the educational purposes. I'm fine with the basic B1 plan. So let's click on review and create, which would give us our web app. So let's click on create. And then I just wanted to show, you know, how you can utilize both CLI if you prefer, you know, the portal through going through the UI, trying to accommodate both of the experiences in this demo, since we created the app service plan using the CLI and then we created the web app using the portal. Okay, so if we go on to the resource itself, you can see it has created us a web app. And if I click on the URL, you'll see it'll welcome us with the default, you know, Azure web app page. I want you to do is now we'll have to download the publish profile, since this will be used as a secret. This will be used as a secret in the GitHub action later. This is how GitHub Actions will authenticate to Azure. So while our Azure web app is still loading, let's go over our GitHub action that will allow us to deploy our personal Python web app to Azure. This is the GitHub action. It helps us build and deploy Python app to Azure web app. You do set some environment variables in the beginning, like the Python version, which we selected for our runtime, and also what the Azure web app name was. And then you can see every time we push to the main branch, this action will run, which means our updates to the code will automatically be deployed to the Azure web app. Here is some more code that helps us setting up the Python environment, right? We did had a lot of libraries that we were using and packages. What it will do is it'll create a virtual environment and we'll also start that. And then it will also install the requirements and dependencies by using requirements.txt. So if I go back to my code editor, you can see I have created requirements.txt, which has pandas, Flask, Plotly, and YFinance. Let's go to our Azure Web Apps-Python YAML. So this is where our action will reside, or the code for our GitHub action will reside. So you have to create a directory. It's a special directory called .github in the root of your GitHub repo. And then you create another directory called workflows where our actions will reside. And then what I have done is created a Azure Web Apps-Python YAML file. And what I'm gonna do is kind of cheating, but there will be some stuff that needs to be updated. So for first, web app name is Python-stocks, right? The runtime we selected 3.8, so that's fine. As I already kind of explained, here we just set up the environment where we install packages, set up virtual environment, we install dependencies and packages that are needed for our app to run. And then if you scroll down, you can see that you can include extra steps here to run testing. PyTest is another package that you can utilize to run tests on your web app here. If you look at the formatting of this actions file, there are jobs that are run. So first job was build, which we utilized to create virtual environment and then install the dependencies. And then we have deploy job that helps us to deploy this web app to Azure. So you can see we have some steps here, right? It utilizes this action that's available on GitHub again, and that GitHub holds the configuration on how a Python web app should be deployed to Azure. And you can see we have two environment variables being used here. So one is the Azure web app name, which we already defined on the top. And the next one is publish profile. And then you can see it has secrets in the front. So this is where we will have to set up secret in our GitHub repository. And it's called Azure web app publish profile. So let's go ahead and do that. So if I go to my GitHub repo for this project, I go to settings, and then you can see that we have secrets on the left hand side. And if I click on actions, I can set up new repository secret. Let's do that. I won't display this on screen since it's the way our GitHub action will authenticate to our Azure web app. I'll just add it and show it later. You can see I have added the Azure web app publish profile secret, and it was updated, 34 seconds ago. And this is also our default web app that we created in Azure. So now, since I feel like our action is righty, right? I have Python stocks as the name. All of the other settings are default. And then we have added this secret to our GitHub action. So if I save this file and commit it to my repo here, so I'll go here and include this, added GitHub action, right? And let's click on commit and click on sync changes, which basically will push my code to GitHub. So now if I open my GitHub repo, there should be an action that is being triggered by our push that we just did. So you can already see added GitHub action was committed 26 seconds ago. You can open the actions through the actions tab. It will take you to our GitHub action that's running right now. You can see the build step has already succeeded, and this is a bunch of jobs that it did. So it set up the Python version, created and started the virtual environment, set up dependency, right? And now what it's doing is it's deploying to our Azure web app. And now you can see the deploy job has also succeeded, or the deploy step has also succeeded. And now if I go back to my Python stocks app, this was the default app that was being served, but let's click on that URL again and see what we are greeted with. And if you're not sure about the URL, it's also being shown on the deploy step. Here is our Python stocks app running on Azure web app, and you can see that by the URL, the page loaded, right? And if we go ahead and click on Microsoft stock, you can see the graph was loaded, and let's see if it's working fine. So let's pick 1 month and then go to 1 day. So we'll get the last 30 days worth of data for our Microsoft stock. And you also get the day high and day low. So there it is. We used GitHub Actions to deploy this. And now every time I make any change to my code, let's say if I want to include more stocks, and let's say I pick maybe some other trending tech stocks to be included, and if I commit those changes to the main branch, all of those will be deployed automatically to our Azure web app using the GitHub Actions. That was a quick video on how you can set up GitHub Actions to deploy your Azure web app. GitHub and Microsoft offer lots of resources to help you get started with GitHub Actions. Visit aka.ms/rk1 to access detailed documentation from GitHub and also a learning path from Microsoft to help you automate workflows with GitHub Actions. I hope you find this video helpful, and I'll see you in the next video with another demo. Until then, peace.